Leonard Bernstein, the first of two composers born in the interval between 1915 and 1925, whose last names start with B, who are very fine composers who conduct the New York Philharmonic at different times. Bernstein, the more well-regarded by his compatriots in the orchestra, like George Gershwin, Duke Ellington, and many others, Bernstein had a foot in, shall we say, both musical camps of the popular and the classical. He does a number of musicals, including, this is Ludoslavsky, look at that, Venetian Games, we don't want that, including West Side Story, which we will do as part of the exam. So we'll focus at this point on just his classical output, does a couple of symphonies, and an extraordinary piece in 1965, Chichester Psalms for the Chichester Cathedral in England. It's a nice Anglican church, and he's a nice Jewish boy from
Lawrence, Massachusetts.
He sets psalms, but he has them do it in Hebrew. Yes, first movement features this chorale-like tune. Chorale, you know, it's Lutheran thing. How about that? But very angular. I suppose that's a do, so mate. Even that's kind of a little blues. It's at the very beginning of the movement. There's an asymmetrical dum, bum, 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 bum. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It comes back at the end of the movement. Our featured movement is the second movement for boy soprano to kind of reflect the fact that the Psalms were written by King David. At least that's the idea, many of the Psalms. And there are three themes in kind of an exposition. First one, and we're in A major, and the first one is sort of so, re, fa, mate, which also seems major, minor, blues kind of thing. Second theme coming down in eighth notes as do, te, te, la, la, which could be kind of a little bit of our favorite Dorian, you never know. And a third theme, which rises like this. So, re, do, re, mi, do, re, mi, do, re, do, me. Definitely blues. Do, re, do, and underneath this chord progression. And if it goes here, that's really the same as what we're getting in a lot of rock and roll tunes, which are written about the same time.
That's 1, minor 6, major 4, major 5.
A little tweakier in that his, he actually goes down to a 2, but it's a blues 2. Oh yeah, with flat 9 going on there. It's 2, a 2, 5, flat 9. Great stuff.
But in Bernstein's usage, 1, minor 6, major 4, your power chord, 2, and then to 5.
That's the exposition, the development we have, and it's the boy soprano and the ladies. We'll only hear the first statement, the first two themes, and then the second statement of the third of those three little themes. Middle piece, it's just the guys, at least initially. There's a correspondence, sort of the male-female split, as we heard in the Mozart Requiem, Confitatus movement, which, and this is reverse of that, which that starts with all the guys and then all the women. Here we have the women and the boy soprano, and now just the testosterone hasn't kicked in. And now, boy, testosterone big time with maybe I better put it down here. Don't be so, don't be so, little so. And so we're definitely in A minor versus A major, the tonic or parallel. Some people like that, not me. Minor. And extraordinarily, he brings the first little theme back over the top. And that's that chorale cantata, like soaring over the top. We heard it in Copland, of course, and so many people, and the activity down the bottom. Brilliant. Since he brings back little theme A, his recapitulation starts with little theme B, which Mozart actually does a lot. A lot of times Mozart will come back to a recapitulation, but he will not start at the beginning, which is the bones of Mozart can be very interesting sometimes. And then the third theme returns, and then a coda, which is based on the development section. And so, like Beethoven, significant codas that seem to be a second development. And there's just a hint of war. First is Psalm 23. The second part is Psalm 2. Why do the nations rage against each other? Why, indeed? And then when it comes back, this underpin. Third movement has the chorale tune done in this intense string version, then a rocking theme in 10-4, Eleanor, and it's in G, and goes, so, la, so, re, do, mi, and then kind of slides around chromatically. And at the very end, the chorale tune one more time. Brilliant.
Thank you.
So many composers coming of age in the mid-20th century doing remarkable things, including George Rochberg, based in Philadelphia, one of three composers that kind of constitute a Philadelphia school. Stylistically eclectic, he evokes Beethoven, Mahler, Bartok, and himself, all in close succession, and we'll hear a little taste of his string quartet number 3. The ongoing tradition of 12-bar blues, it just won't quit, and it's always wonderful. A little road tripping with Bobby Troup with Get Your Kicks on Route 66, which has been covered by numerous artists, including some of the old crooners and the Rolling Stones. Alexander Courage, the first composer hired for Star Trek. Your typical television show will often go through many composers or have various people hired for different episodes, and so it's almost a Wagnerian whispering down the lane. Everybody takes the sourdough seed material and expands upon it. So a television show lasts a few years, and you get really a magnum opus, sometimes rivaling a Wagnerian cycle. That also happens, of course, in movies with sequels. And for Star Trek, what are you going to do to symbolize outer space? How about quartal harmony? How about evoking both Mahler and Schoenberg? And in that order, the descending fourths, maybe from the first movement of the First Symphony. And I think we're in A here. So that would be do, and that would be do, so, te, re, do, fa, te. So you got the fourths going down, and the upper ones, and of course that upper one, the rocket ship from Schoenberg, Bartok et al.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its 5-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before.
Arnold, continuing the neoclassic tradition with a little sardonic twist, a very, very grand overture, which includes music for several vacuum cleaners, a floor polisher, and gunshots. Not terribly politically appropriate, I must say.